Welcome to the online class, Subject Science, Class 7. Unit 5, Basis of Classification. When you get ready to go to school, all your things like uniform, lunchbox, water bottle, shoes, etc. to be kept ready. Just imagine, if all these things are not ready, you will need to spend too much of time to collect them. Likewise, in a grocery shop, medical shop, bakery, library, so in all the places, all the items are systematically arranged to make your work easier. So sorting of things is very much required and important for all living beings. We see various plants and animals around us. It is estimated that about 8.7 million species of living organisms have been identified and named till now. However, many scientists believe that only a small portion of a total species existing on Earth has been identified. In order to know about the behavior and relationship among organisms, that are known, biologists have classified them into two broad groups. So, the grouping of living organisms based on their common features is known as biological classification. So, according to that, they are grouped the organisms into two types, that is, plants and animals. Look at the things here: chair, table, blackboard, chalk piece, cupboard, fan, light, switches, school bag, lunch bag, textbook, notebook, and water bottle. So many things are there. So we have to classify them. How to classify them? First, find out one common difference among these materials to classify the things into two, that is, wooden and non-wooden things. First, we have to take the one common difference, that is wooden and non-wooden things. Then, find out another difference to classify each group into two subgroups, that is wooden sitting materials and wooden writing materials, and also non-wooden sitting materials and non-wooden writing materials. So, next step, we have to continue to identify differences to classify each small subgroups into two, that is fixed or portable and with arm and without arm. So like that, we have to classify the similarities and differences of the things. So there are some similarities and differences exist among these materials. So we need to observe and identify those similarities and differences to construct a dichotomous key. So, according to this, we have to classify them like this. Imagine this is a classroom. So, the classroom materials we have to classify. First, wooden materials and non-wooden materials. So, we have to classify the first common difference, wooden and non-wooden materials. In wooden materials, we have two subgroups, writing materials, sitting materials. In writing materials, again we two small subgroups, that is fixed and portable. In fixed, what are the things are comes under? Blackboard with wooden frame. Then portable, pencil, wooden scale, color pencil, eraser, book and notebooks. So let me come to the sitting materials, with arm and without arm. So chair has come under the with arm, then table is without arm. So like that we have to classify. Then under non-wooden materials, writing materials and sitting materials. In writing materials again fixed and portable. So in fixed, blackboard with blackboard, whiteboard. Then in portable, pens, ruler, color pencil, pencil box, chalk pieces. These are non-wooden portable materials. Then under sitting materials, chair comes under with arm, that is iron or plastic chair, that is a non-wooden material. Then iron or plastic table is comes under without arm. So like that we can able to classify the things for our quick work or easier work. So what is the dichotomous key? Let me see about the dichotomous key. It is a tool used to classify organisms based on their similarities and differences. It has some features. What are the features of dichotomous key? First, a single feature that differentiates a group easily. First, we have to take a single feature that a common difference that differentiates a group easily. Then one character selected to separate the group as present or absent, like that with arm or without arm, like that we have to take. Then continue the second step until only one item will remain at the end. So this is the features of dichotomous key. Then we have to see about the dichotomy of animals. For example, now observe these pictures. Using a dichotomy pattern, classify the given list of animals like ostrich, peacock, monkey, frog, toad, turtle, snake, shark, goldfish, ant, tapeworm, earthworm, and leech. So we have to classify these animals. Various types of animals are given here. Animals and worms are given here. So we have to classify them for our easier identification. So we can use the dichotomous key here. So how we classify? First, take the first step. Presence or absence of backbone. This is a main common difference among these animals. Main common differentiate presence or absence of backbone. So we can classify them into two groups according to that, with the backbone and without backbone. Then second step, animals with backbone can be divided into its subgroup based on its body temperature. So all the backbone having animals are comes under one group, and that's also again divided into subgroup based on their body temperature. Then third step, further classification can be done based on its differences like presence of feather or hair or scales, etc. So like this we can classify these animals into different groups. For this it is useful for us, the dichotomous key is very useful for us. So hope you understand about the dichotomous key and its features. So let me meet in the next session with the basis of classification. Thank you, children.